It's no secret that AI is developing at an incredibly fast rate. But what happens when an AI-powered robot goes head-to-head against human soldiers in a real-life combat situation? Recently, the US government developed an AI-powered robot to assist the military in complex, time-critical war situations, and once it was ready, they tested it on a group of 8 Marines on the battleground. Who came on top in this epic showdown? And what could this mean for the future of military AI? Watch until the end of this video to find out. Before we get into what went down, here's a little bit of backstory. In 2019, DARPA created a program called Squad X with the goal of integrating autonomous AI systems into the US military to help foot soldiers gain an edge over small enemy units. But how exactly did they plan to do that? Well, the idea was to create an AI system that could detect human subjects from a long distance using long-range sensors and cameras. If all went well, the system would be used both on drones and ground robots, and it would eventually be taken overseas for combat. According to Stuart Young, the program manager and tactical technology officer for the Squad X program, there were 4 main areas of focus for the development of this technology.
We're focusing on autonomous mobility, intelligent planning, and multi-agent control.
The first area is precision engagement. Precision engagement basically means that for the program to be considered successful, the robots would need to be trained to engage enemies using the same weapon systems that US military already uses. The goal in this area was for the robots to learn to target threats that lie outside of the squad's direct line of sight using guided munitions, all without slowing down the rest of the squad. The second area is non-kinetic engagement. This means that the AI should be able to interfere with enemy communications electronically and give the squad an accurate representation of where the enemy's weapon systems are located. This would require the AI to not only recognize human subjects based on their movement patterns, but also unmanned weapon systems that could threaten the safety of the squad. The third area is squad sensing. This is one of the most important areas of the program. Squad sensing means that the AI has to be able to detect enemy movement completely autonomously using cameras and long-range sensors, and then relay that information instantly to the squad without slowing anyone down. This would pretty much turn the AI into an early warning system that could alert the squad about incoming threats, such as ambushes and surprise attacks. The advantages to developing something like this before an enemy squad does are incredible. Imagine having a robot that can scout out a battleground and bring the squad all the information it needs before actually engaging in battle. It goes without saying that this would be a total game changer. And finally, the fourth area of the Squad X program is squad autonomy. In a combat situation, it's of course very important for squad members to know the location of their fellow foot soldiers. Squad autonomy means that the AI can locate squad members autonomously through the use of unmanned ground and air systems without using GPS. One of the coolest features of this program is that once the AI has scouted the battlefield for potential threats and has surveyed the overall layout of the battleground, the data is synced in real time with the soldier's handheld devices. It's like having an iPad that gives you an in-depth report of the battleground's conditions, from the presence of enemy threats to other objects or points of interest on the ground and in the air. Now, you might be thinking that an AI that can do all of this, with no human intervention, would be something out of a Terminator movie, but it's important to remember one thing. One of the main rules of AI is that an AI system is only as good as the data it's trained on, which brings an interesting twist to the story. In order for DARPA's AI system to be as effective as possible in real-life combat situations, it would need to be trained using human subjects in a real war scenario. The only way to do this would be to run a combat simulation involving the AI-powered robot and a group of Marines. So, the engineers from DARPA got together with a group of 8 Marines for a week at the Marine Corps Air Ground Combat Center in 29 Palms, California, to train the AI. During the first 6 days, everything went according to plan. The AI system monitored the behavior of the Marines during their activities, while the engineers from DARPA trained the AI to recognize human subjects and classify their movements as either threatening or non-threatening. Everything seemed to be going just dandy, so after just 6 days of training, DARPA engineers decided that it was time to put their AI system to the test against the group of 8 Marines. The test consisted of a game in which the robot would be placed on the ground and the Marines would start from about 1,000 feet away. Each person could use whatever method they wanted to hide from the AI, and if they managed to sneak up on the robot and touch it without being identified as a human by the AI, then the Marines would win. If the AI detected human subjects at any point during the game, the Marines would lose. Now, realizing that they were very unlikely to beat the AI if they just walked up to it from 1,000 feet away, the Marines decided to get creative to outsmart the machine. So what happened? Well, according to former Pentagon policy analyst Paul Scharr, who published this story in his most recent book, 4 Battlegrounds: Power in the Age of Artificial Intelligence, the game took a bit of an unexpected turn. 2 of the Marines decided to shake things up and did somersaults for 1,000 feet until they reached the robot. Another one decided to strip the leaves from a fir tree, cover himself with the leaves, and, in Paul Scharr's own words, walk like a fir tree all the way to the robot. At this point, we don't know who was more confused between the AI and the DARPA engineers, who probably just sat there simultaneously facepalming as they watched their carefully engineered AI system get fooled by the Marines' clever tricks. But the fun didn't stop there. Another two of the Marines hid inside a cardboard box and walked all the way to the robot completely undetected. According to Paul Scharr, they could be heard giggling the entire time they were walking. Out of the eight Marines that participated in the test, not a single one was detected as human. Now, this would probably be enough to drive any engineer crazy, but according to Paul Scharr, the program manager was actually very appreciative that this happened at a test site and not overseas in an actual war zone. There's a ton of valuable lessons to learn from what happened at the test site. Most importantly, it's pretty clear that AI is still far from being combat ready, and if it was used in an actual war zone in its current state, it would probably only slow down the entire operation and do more harm than good. Remember when we talked about an AI system only being as good as the data it's trained on? This is one of the key takeaways from this program. The main reason the AI failed the test against the Marines is because it was only trained to recognize normal human behavior and movements, such as walking, running, and jumping. It wasn't trained to recognize giggling Marines hiding inside cardboard boxes or camouflaging themselves with fig tree leaves. The AI was trained to recognize predictable patterns, and let's face it, in a war zone, the enemy will be anything but predictable. But regardless of the outcome of the test, it's still amazing to see how far military AI has come in the past 10 years. Keep in mind that 30 years ago, the internet was barely being made available to the general public, and now the government is developing robot dogs and drones that, in a few years' time, will be able to run, fly, and identify enemy threats without the need for human interaction, revolutionizing the very nature of armed combat. The first versions of any type of system are never attractive, but we have to start somewhere. Just take a second to compare the appearance of the GameCube with the newest Xbox console, or the newest iPhone with the first flip phone. Technology has developed incredibly quickly in every other industry over these past two decades, and the same thing will happen with AI. The future of artificial intelligence is exciting, and we can't wait to see what comes next.